It's time to play Family Feud. Our returning champs, the Addams Family, playing against the Linder Family. Now, here's the star of our show, Rowdy Mr. Richard.
Thank you very much, and welcome back to the Family Feud. We have, returning for their second time, our champions, the Addams Family. Aaron.
Hi.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
How you doing?
I'm good, thank you.
All right. Well, introduce me once again to your family.
This is my mom, Pam, mm-hmm. my uncle, Kirk, my dad, Mark, and my brother, Jeremy.
All right. And they are playing against the Linder Family. Mandy.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm well, thank you.
All right, well, introduce me to your family.
Well, this is my my husband, Marcus, uh-huh. my sister, Corey, hi. My brother-in-law, Darrow, and last but not least, my dad, Steve.
Okay, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Aaron, are you playing?
Yes,
let's play the feud. All right, good luck, you guys. We have surveyed 100 people. Top 8 answers are on our board. Give me the most popular answer. Give me a phrase that starts with the words off the... Mandy.
Off the cuff.
Off the cuff. Two answers better than that, Aaron.
Off the hook.
Off the hook. Oh! Perfect. Okay, they're playing. You're off the hook. Pam, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
What do you think? What starts with the words off the...
Off the wall.
Off the wall.
Good answer.
Off the wall. Number one answer. Kirk.
Off the top.
Off the top?
Yeah. Good answer, Kirk.
Off the top. Just a little off the top.
Just a little.
It was just below the line, I guess. Mark.
Off the road.
Off the road.
Yes. Good answer.
The very polite way of... I just bought an off-the-road vehicle.
Off the road.
Linder Family, that's 2 strikes. Get ready. All right, Jeremy.
Off the charts.
Off the charts.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
If that's there, you're still alive. If not, the Linder Family gets a chance to steal. This is off the charts. Aaron.
I got it.
Okay.
Off the rim.
Off the rim.
Off the rim.
Okay. If that is up there, it's nothing but net. And Pam, I'm coming to you.
Okay.
Otherwise, the Linders get a chance to steal. Off the rim. Uh-oh.
Off the record.
Off the mark.
Off the record.
Off the record.
Off the record.
Off the mark.
Off the record.
Off the record. Off the mark. Off the top of your head, what do you think?
I'm going to go with off the record.
Oh, yeah. Good answer. All right.
Off the record. Boy, I might have just said one of the answers. I'm glad you came up with something different. Okay, off the record. If it's there, you've stolen the points, taken first blood. Off the record. All right. What's up there? What's number 6? And number 7? Off the top of the head. I did that, didn't I? And what's number 8?
Off the rack.
Off the rack. Pam. Marcus. All right, good luck. Now remember, it's the first team to 300 points gets that shot at $20,000. Top 6 answers are on the board. Tell me one thing people know about Shrek. Marcus.
He's a monster.
He is a monster. Pam.
He's an ogre.
He's an ogre. Fire pass.
We're going to play a pass.
We're going to play.
Okay, they're playing. That's right. You know, not all ogres are monsters.
That's right.
Look at Shrek. Okay, Kirk.
I'd have to say it's a movie.
It's a movie.
Yeah. Good answer. Good answer.
It's a movie.
Mark. He lives in a swamp.
He lives in the swamp?
Yes.
He lives in the swamp.
Oh, that was a good answer, though. Jeremy, what do people know about Shrek?
He's friends with a donkey.
Yes, good answer. Good answer, Jeremy. All right.
A donkey on the edge.
Yes,
he is. He's friends with a donkey.
Oh, two strikes, you guys. Get ready. Okay, Aaron.
He's green.
Yeah.
He is green. He's green.
Okay. You need this to be up there because you already have two strikes. He's green. All right. She's kept you alive one more time, Pam.
Oh, let's see.
What else
see.
Do people know about Shrek?
He has a good heart.
That's why he's not a monster. He has a good heart. All right, if it's up there, you're still alive. Kirk, I'd be coming to you. If not, the lenders get a chance to steal. He has a good heart. Once again, they've kept you alive.
I'd have to say he's in love with Fiona.
Good answer! Yeah.
And he even remembered her name.
Yes.
Kirk, you have a good heart. Okay, if it's there, you're still alive. I'd be coming to you. He's in love with Fiona. Uh-oh.
What do you think?
Play
with
Mike Myers.
I'll go with my family. Yeah. He's played by Mike Myers.
You mean he's not real?
That's what I heard.
Okay, if it's up there, you guys, once again, I've stolen the points from our champions. He's played by Mike Myers. Oh. Oh. What do you guys think? What's number three? Well, we knew that. What's number four?
Hey.
All right. The Linder family at 79. The Adams family at 66. But our goal is 300 points. Don't go away. Come on back. We'll be waiting for you. Come on. Welcome back to the Family Feud. The Linder family at 79, the Adams family at 66. Kirk, Corey. All right, guess what? I'm doubling the points. It's still anybody's game. Top six answers are on the board. Name something you'd expect to see inside a police car. Corey.
Walkie-talkie.
A walkie-talkie.
We have to play.
Okay, they're playing. They are playing. All right, Gerald.
I'm going to have to say a gun.
Oh, that's good.
Good answer.
A gun. Yeah.
In the back seat, a prisoner.
A prisoner.
A prisoner. All right, Mandy.
Well, if you're going to have a prisoner, you've got to have a policeman.
That's oh, yeah.
That's right.
You better.
Yeah.
You better have one.
A policeman.
Yeah.
Mark it. Two more up there.
How about handcuffs?
Handcuffs?
That's good. Yeah.
All right. Handcuffs.
All right. All right.
All right. All right. Answer.
Corey.
A cage.
A cage.
Oh, yeah.
There's a criminal and a policeman in a cage.
Right. Kind of like a taxi.
I think so.
Can't touch the taxi driver.
Oh, yeah.
Can't touch the police officer. Okay, if it's there, you've swept the board. If not, it's just your first strike. We're looking for cage.
Oh.
All right, Darryl.
I got it.
You got it?
Yep.
Okay.
Radar gun.
Oh,
great answer. Great answer. Man. All right. If that's there, you guys have swept the board. If not, Steve, it comes up to you.
right.
No pressure?
No pressure.
But we think it's up there, don't we?
I think so.
It's a radar.
It's
on the radar.
Yep.
Radar, gun. Adam's family, get ready. All right, Steve.
A video camera.
A video camera. Oh.
That's right.
Bad boys, bad boys. How else do we get all that footage?
That's right.
Okay, if it's there, you guys have swept the board. If not, the Adams family gets a chance to steal, and they are very anxious. We're looking for a video camera. What do I hear?
Flashlight.
A nightstick, a flashlight.
Computer.
We're going to say flashlight.
Flashlight. Computer.
Flashlight. Flashlight.
Computer's good, too, but flashlight. Okay, if that's there, you've stolen the points this time back from the lenders. If not, they get to keep those 158 points. Flashlight. All good answers. But what's number six? Computer. Pam had it. The lenders at 237. The Adams at 66. It's still anybody's game. Don't go away. We have a computer screen right here. We'll tell you who wins right after this. All right, welcome back to the Family Feud. The Linders at 237. Our champions, the Adams family, they got a strike now. Mark, Daryl. This is such a good game, I'm tripling the points. I'm only reading the question once, though, okay? So, Jeremy, Steve, everybody pay attention. Top four answers on the board. Name something a high school student looks forward to. Mark.
Summer.
Summer. Two answers better, Bill.
Graduation.
Graduation. Okay, they're playing. I know, then they spend 30 years trying to get back there. Steve.
The prom.
Oh, that's right.
Prom. All right, Mandy. This is for the win. This is a big thing.
It is, it is. Lunch.
Yes, yes.
Every day I look forward to that.
I know. My son says that's his favorite subject. All right, if it is up there, you guys have taken all the points and the game.
Woo!
If not, it's just your first strike. We're looking for lunch. That's all right. Marcus, that was a good answer.
Thank you.
I have to go with recess.
Oh, yeah. That's good. Yeah, that's good.
Good answer. Good answer.
Okay. It's up there. You guys won the game, but Corey, get ready.
I am.
Recess. We all look forward to recess.
Yeah.
You don't have to be. Corey.
Study hour.
Study hour. I know. A hush came over the crowd. They weren't sure, okay? If it is up there, you guys got the points. If not, the Adams family gets a chance to steal, to get back, and, well, actually, to win the game. Oh. Study hall.
College.
They all had the same answer. Do you have a different one?
No. They're looking forward to college.
They're looking forward to college.
To their careers. To college and their career.
Okay. This is something a high school student looks forward to. Recess was gone long ago. Okay, if it's college is up there, you guys retain the championship. College. High school. Who's playing? Oh, look, she's emotional. All right, guys. One on one side, one on the other. We'll be back to play Fast Money right after this. Don't go away. The Adams family came back to win the game. It's time to play Fast Money for $20,000. Now, Mark's off stage. We can't see or hear your answers. I'll ask you five questions in 20 seconds. Try to give me the most popular answer. If you can't think of something, say pass. And we'll come back to it if there's time left. Now, if you and Mark together get 200 points, you will win
$20,000.
You ready? 20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name the heaviest thing in your house.
The dog.
How long do kids spend on their homework each night?
2 hours.
Name something people do just before eating dinner.
Brush their teeth.
Name something you find in a taco.
Meat.
Name a holiday you spend the most time preparing for.
Christmas.
All right. All right. How do you feel?
Okay.
Okay, good. All right. The heaviest thing in your house is a dog. Are you sure it's a dog? You're not, it's not a horse. It's a dog. Okay. Survey said. All right. That's okay. We got that one out of the way. How long do kids spend on their homework each night? You said 2 hours. Survey said 21.
That's good. You're on the board.
Something people do just before eating dinner. You said they brush their teeth. That's right, because there's dog hairs or something. I don't know. Survey said zero. All right. Something you find in a taco. You said meat. Survey said that's what we want to see. All right. How about the holiday that you spend the most time preparing for? You said Christmas. Survey said
yeah.
All right. Clear the board. Clear the board. Mark, guess what? Kirk got you 114 points. You need 86. I will ask you the same five questions. You can't duplicate the answers. If you do, you'll hear this sound. I'll say try again. Give me a different answer. It's tougher, so we'll give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Remind everyone of Kirk's answers. 25 seconds on the clock. Time will start after I read the first question. Name the heaviest thing in your house.
Refrigerator.
How long do kids spend on their homework each night?
1 hour.
Name something people do just before eating dinner.
Say the prayers.
Name something you find in a taco.
Cheese.
A holiday you spend the most time preparing for.
Thanksgiving.
Wow. All right. All right. 86 points you need. The heaviest thing in your house is a refrigerator. Right next to that big dog. Probably can open the refrigerator. The survey said yeah! Number one answer. Number one answer. Refrigerator. How long do kids spend on their homework each night? You said 1 hour. Okay. 2 minus 1. I didn't do my homework. 56 points. Survey said 1 hour is the number one answer.
Yes.
Okay. It's because they're grooming that big dog. Something people do just before eating dinner. You said they say their prayers. Survey said. Yeah! The number one answer, ground beef, number one answer, and Christmas. That is a 2-day total of $20,950. But say your prayers, because they're coming back tomorrow to fight off another family for another shot at $20,000 right here on the Family Feud. I'm Richard Karn. I'll be waiting for you. Come on back.